last time was simple.
Yeah. Hope
fought a big man, defeated a big man, fought a man his size, was promptly defeated by man his size.
I wasn't promptly defeated. It was before even.
Yeah, the fight
It's all right, Zach. You're still pretty.
It was pretty even, and I'm okay to take third place as a bard. Yeah, thank you very much.
That was a little bit of revisionist history there on his end.
He's the DM, he can revise what he wants.
Yeah, well, yeah, Victor gets to revise whatever what he wants, so.
Well, I mean, it was a pretty good fight. Everyone had fun.
It was epic.
Except for,
That's not how you use the word epic.
You lost, sorry.
Yeah, I mean,
Coat didn't have fun because at the end of the fight, he still got a giant headbutt to knock him out. But,
Yeah, but he earned that headbutt. So.
Oh, he earned it. And after another night of partying, the day of the finale, the grand finals, has finally arrived.
Huh. A lot of finales.
Yes.
And it's... Like, are we just going to go straight to the tournament?
Well, I mean, you guys wake up at the Golem's Arm currently.
About 3 p.m. Drink about 16 cups of coffee. Yeah? Sounds about right.
No, you'll have missed the tournament.
Yeah, I'm just like at 8 a.m., I was like, I'm reading a book. Like, what the f-
Yep, you guys basically just, wake up and, yeah. It's another day.
Cope pops to Advil. As I cast healing word on myself. Specifically, ye old Advil. Specifically in the Nugget region.
Oh my god.
I didn't know that word of power. That's an interesting one.
Ye old nuggets, heal thyself.
I said nugget, not nuggets. You fucking perverts.
You only have one testicle?
Well played.
It doesn't make you any less of a man.
Well, you couldn't use heal thyself without, you know, the plural.
Technically, it does.
Yeah. Position heal thyself.
Oh, well, maybe.
Okay, so anyway. Everybody wanders downstairs or is upstairs or something. Did anybody know to collect Talon for the finale from here?
Well, I'm... Yeah.
Okay.
Do you think they would send someone to collect Talon?
I don't know. They were sending someone to collect Coat.
Yeah, but no one here likes Talon.
And I'm shoving him out the door and we're going. Okay. We're not late, are we?
No, you're still actually fairly early. This is still earlier than when Coat usually gets picked up.
I don't know if I trust it.
Yeah, the nobles do tend to snuff him.
Nub, not snuff. Snuff means murder.
They're trying.
Yeah, I chose my words properly.
Oh, God.
What did Tarek do?
I don't want to know.
I was seeing if I trust it.
Okay. That's insight.
Trust.
And by trust it, I mean pickpocket it.
20 on a pickpocket roll? I don't think so.
He's like, that's really low.
Like, you somehow steal their armor. Like, how?
No, have you ever seen The Gamers? The guy's like, what does this guy got? He's like, oh, he's got some gold. I'll try to steal that. Roll it. He does. He's like, does he have any weapons on him? Yeah, he's got a dagger. I'll steal that too. Like, all right. I want to steal his pants. You want to what? He's like, I want to steal his pants. He's like, why do you want his pants? I don't want him. I just want to see if I could do it. It's like, all right, roll it, but you suffer a -8 penalty to difficulty. Brah. And then you see the character, like, you see the thief basically just fucking, like, whap a pair of pants, like, out of the... from the bar patron who's literally just sitting on a stool at the bar. He's just like, pants, bam!
And the asshole is still standing.
This is from The Gamers, by the way. If you have not seen that show, you need to. They are great. They're all free on YouTube.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Continue.
On that note, I guess we head to the tournament. Might as well show up early. Get good seats.
Indeed. We're going to stand at the edge of the ring the entire time anyway.
Oh, yeah. But I was considering for you.
Can I
have all my shit with me. Armor, spear, the works.
Taking everything.
You go places without that stuff?
No, I'm just always scared he's going to be like, you didn't say so.
I sleep in my... I do now, too.
Yeah. Hooray for not needing sleep.
I have two hatchets under my pillow with daggers in my hands.
God, I think I'm poisoned!
He sleeps as a direwolf, so, you know.
Yeah.
She'll be the one to save all our half-dead asses, because someone will find the weak point in our armor while we snore. She'll be like, nope, not today.
Yeah, but then again, she's the one that sometimes sleepwalks, so she
right,
might...
Right, so you won't be awake for it. Nah, you won't be awake for it.
Wait,
you'll
can't
save
you
us.
Can't you leave in a direwolf for like 3 hours?
She's
well,
unconscious.
Technically she's resting.
Same team, asshole.
I'm just saying, you wouldn't want to rely on that and have there be a glaring weakness. It's like, oh, I'm going to sleep as a cat on top of a bookshelf. 4 hours later, poof, bam! It's like, what happened?
That would be hilarious.
Well, it's like, I view it as this. Considering that the wild change comes back after a short rest, if she's resting while in the form, it doesn't affect her.
That's genius, actually.
True, but it requires an action to reset it.
Bonus action.
She sleep actioned it.
Yeah. she just like kicks her leg a little bit and it's like and then it resets.
Actually, I'm now imagining the crow does it. He like finds a little switch on the back of her head. As soon as she walks back, she like flips it. Wait, wouldn't that use your charge for the next day then?
Enough theory crafting. We're going to the tournament. All right,
too much. We go to the tournament. Go to the tournament. Fine. We take everything we need and everything we're working on. We go to the tournament.
I'm already here. Looks like Talon's in the ring, just standing there waiting.
Did we warn him about the presence of the dude with the... Oh, no, he's been at the tournament. Ignore me. I'm like, yeah. He's gonna... I keep thinking he's gonna have PTSD flashbacks about the Krim and all those guys. I don't know. I have this horrible fear he's gonna shut down when we need him to fight.
Well, Coke can switch out with him.
Oh, right! The switch-outy thingy. Yeah,
it's
yeah.
It's not gonna work for the tournament. It's just gonna get him disqualified.
Who cares if somebody gets a...
If this tournament is going to be screwed over probably anyway.
Yeah, there is that.
If shit goes to hell, switch with them.
Let's see what Sean says, because he's been so quiet.
So you guys are heading off to the arena then?
Yes.
Yep. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Windy outside.
Man, that's good RP. You step outside into a brisk gale.
Well, you basically walk out, and there the streets are almost choked with people. There are tons of people heading to the arena.
I give the I give like the finger pistols and a snap finger pistols and smiles at people as I walk by.
I look down at what the hell he's trying to do.
What? No, I'm you know I'm playing up my fans because I imagine I'm passing by. People are going, "Hey, that was the guy."
Yeah, Ledger's shoving Talon through to make sure he gets there on
time.
But
more people are focused on the finals than the third place.
Oh! Yeah, nobody remembers who got third place. Sorry.
I mean, bronze medal's still
the
medal.
Everyone's
goddamn.
Just so focused on this fight. You could probably just take their pants and they wouldn't notice at this point. Like,
don't
this
give them ideas. We don't have time for that.
The whole year has been built up to. I want to see how it ends. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge.
Round one.
Animals, animal. Oh, that's weird. But,
ginger ale. Oh, that's right. I gotta turn on those on.
That's weird.
Uh-oh. Is he loading music, or...?
No, I was looking at my hand. as fun as that would be. But, yeah, you guys head to the arena. Talon is separated from you as he sort of goes to his little area. I only have him in the center here just for ease. But, yeah. You can see the stadium itself is utterly packed. If you thought it was heavily packed before, it is just, like, bulging at the seams.
Ooh. That means pockets are bulging at the seams.
Are we going to try and place a bet on him?
I mean, Talon is pretty sexy.
Before we forget this time, are we actually going to place a bet on
him? Oh, yeah. Hey, Sean, what are the odds on him, on the fight?
At the moment, odds are slim in against Talon. Mm-hmm. When you have an entire bracket quit, it sort of increases your odds.
I'm gonna put 100 gold on Talon.
I feel like the fight won't even finish.
That's exactly. Where I'm expecting
it'll be interrupted by chaos or something.
That's fine.
And?
I'm not betting.
All right.
No. Can I not bet that Talon wins? Can I just bet the other guy loses?
I mean, you could in horse racing, but...
The bookie gives you a very odd look. It's just like, I guess I'll take that bet.
All right, then.
I'm not sure that how that works out, but...
I'm gonna put 1,000 gold on it, then.
All right. On him losing.
No, yes. on the other guy losing, yeah. Not Talon winning. Yeah. Yeah.
It's genius. Means we could just disqualify him.
No, just, things happen.
Okay, so
I give him a wink and I say I'll be back to collect my money later.
Okay. Actually, how crowded is it around the bookie?
Oh, for God's sake!
He's like, what? I need gambling money.
Like, this is the Super Bowl. Let's be clear. This is the Super Bowl.
It is a Super Bowl.
I made that joke last session, remember?
Yeah.
That was the only sports reference that stuck, actually.
That was the road to the Super Bowl. This is the actual Super Bowl. Like,
Lord. Is it, like, really crowded around them? Is that what I know?
It is really crowded, but the bookie has several guards around him as well. This isn't the first time he would potentially be robbed.
Can I see that gleam in Tarek's eye that I'm gonna steal shit I shouldn't steal gleam and try to stop him?
Why would you rob the bookie? Rob the people giving the bookie money.
Because the bookie has all the money?
The bookie is a challenge for him.
Oh. Yeah, pick him.
Yeah, but I would have no reason to unless I thought he was going to do it. So do I roll for that to try to see the gleam in his eye?
Okay, perception check.
Why do you need to see the gleam in his eye? You know he's up to something.
Shit!
Yeah, I'm kind of... If I'm breathing, then I'm up to something.
Ooh.
I sell those in my store.
Yeah, the flavor-breathing dragons.
Yeah.
Is perception of 10 enough to know better and just scoop them up and carry them away? Please. I don't want to have to bail his ass out of jail. Shit! Well, would that be stealth or deception? Are you trying to slip away from my sight or lie with your eyes?
If you can't see him, you can't see his eyes.
You can't see me eyes, so...
But not looking for you would make me more concerned. Or not seeing you, rather, would make me more concerned.
How many guards are there?
Oh, God.
There's, like, 6 around him.
So, like, surround him 360 style?
Yeah, they're like, one on each. Basically, think of, like, hex style.
Okay.
Don't make Sean draw another battle map.
He won't, he'll just show it off to the side of this one.
He'll be like, and Tarek has been imprisoned for the rest of his life.
Fix a lock, gets out.
So ends Tarek's story.
So tempted, though. So. Wait, Well, I know. This will decide it. I'm doing it. Okay.
Oh, God.
Hey, that's the closest I can get to a will save, so...
No, it's damn good RP trying to decide if he knows better or doesn't, and he doesn't.
I just checked my Twitch chat after a while, and it says, shut up, Amanda, plus one follow.
I have no idea who said that.
I love that. Okay. So, I'm going to try and slip through the crowd and try to take some of the money.
All right.
Just want me to roll my sleight of hand or another stealth? I don't know.
Oh, no. Just roll your sleight of hand if you want to do this.
Watch, he only steals Coates' money.
Shut up! Oh, no!
So?
Terrible roll.
One of the guards grabs you by the wrist and literally pushes you, throws you away. He goes, if I see you again, I'm going to take your hand. Before he looks around and goes back into his position.
Statistically, Josh, that was a really low roll. You have a much higher chance of trying again and actually succeeding.
But he thinks better of
that. He's like, no, I'm not buying. He's like, no, I'm not buying that.
No, I kind of like my hands.
He's even a wisdom saving throw against his own better judgment.
Yeah.
You rolled a 4. You rolled a 4 and got a 15. Fuck you.
That shit got me.
Yeah. Okay. Continue.
Yep.
I had to try, okay?
The person who said that comment on my Twitter, on my Twitch, by the way, is called Innuendo.
Wow.
I appreciated the pun.
So, the fight starts?
Please.
before.
Make a perception.
Who?
Everyone?
I'm so rusty, I don't know where the skills are.
I'm the best at perception. Like, let's talk about perception here for a second. I've got the best perception. Like, literally, that perception just got 10 feet taller.
Ooh, Treat got natural 20.
Is everyone rolling this?
If you want to.
Seriously?
I mean, I'm still worried about what the Nazis said.
How did Rox get a 6?
She rolled a 3.
Like, I rolled a 3. Yeah. That was...
She's supposed to be the highest of our perception.
No, she's got the highest wisdom.
She's not proficient in it.
Yeah, that's...
How are you not proficient in perception?
I have no idea. I probably should be, but I...
It's her character the way she wants to. Let her...
It's fine. It's okay. Wait, calm
did she add proficiencies?
I don't know. That's a good question.
Because we had that problem last time with... She didn't have health.
How many proficiencies do you have?
I did mean to ask you guys about feats earlier. I'll take care of that this week. But
yeah, don't worry. We'll edit the character in post. Don't worry.
I probably should have proficiency in wisdom, but that is not proficient here. I don't know if it should be or not.
What kind of proficiencies do you have?
Well, it's this, just this like will... what.
Yeah, we'll fix it later. Okay.
Yeah, we'll fix it later.
Let's see. Let me look real quick. Perception. Okay. So it would be Ledger. Let's see, Ledger.
And Treat.
And Treat. Yeah, pretty much. Ledger and Treat both notice some that there's fewer people watching this fight on the sort of noble side of the arena. not in the sense that the nobles of Crossway aren't there. There are plenty of them there, and you can tell based off of a few looks that it's more than likely that a few of them wish to see Talon get crushed. But the ambassador of Dol'Garoth is not there. The giant black armored figure. The sorcerer king, so to speak.
Who was he again?
That's the. That's the guy who intimidated Coat at the party, and he's the dude with his dude's the stretchy arm.
His champion's the one who's currently fighting.
Stretchy arm.
and he's not there to watch his champion fight. That's suspicious.
Yeah, that.
That's not a good sign.
All right.
Does anybody have message? Can we let Talon know that?
I have.
I feel like he deserves to know that.
I do not.
Oh man, if only someone learned the spell sending and could send a message to anyone they've ever met in their life. Regardless,
would my message even get through to him because of the magic barrier?
No.
Well, he's not in the arena yet, is he?
Oh, I forgot.
I say you can just fucking yell at him.
He's not out there yet. The icon is there, but he hasn't come out to start the fight yet.
That icon begs to differ.
That's just because Sean just found it.
I assume we can send someone to go find him.
By then, the fight will start. I know how this works. Okay, well, at least I make the rest of the group aware of that, so everybody's at the ready, on guard, whatever.
Yep. There are a couple other people missing, just a few nobles that you can see aren't there. More than likely, it's because they're probably being dicks. You can also see that the princess from the Kral Alliance... Princess Catherine and her guard are not there. So, for what reason, you can't really tell.
Is my elven lady here somewhere?
No.
Damn it.
She's not really well enough to pull that off.
I was hoping maybe she had a good week.
Well, she wouldn't. She may not have come because you weren't fighting then.
She didn't come when I was fighting either.
Did you ask?
No, I just kind of make that assumption. Like, I just assume people will show up whenever I'm nearby.
Oh. Well, then.
Fun times.
Yep. But yeah, you notice that those people aren't there.
We can do nothing but ready.
Yeah.
We'll keep an eye to the sky.
Seems it takes a little bit longer for this time to sort of get going again, as there's a lot more seeming preparation going on. There's a few musicians, trumpeters sort of getting ready. There's people with like, I wouldn't say confetti, but like you know, just sort of flower petals. It looks like
shit
it's
to
going
throw.
To be this whole show.
Shit to throw, people.
Yeah.
I mean, as a bard, I've got a full range of tomatoes, right? Like, I've just got them laid out, ready to go. Right?
We have a bag of
potatoes.
No, I said tomatoes.
We don't care. That's not what we have stock in.
We are not getting a separate bag of holding full of an uncountable amount of tomatoes.
Hello, I'm a bard.
You also have a corpse in your bag.
Yeah, I keep forgetting about that.
Actually, technically, don't you have a corpse in the bag?
No, it's in my bag.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he took it instead of me. I took the cursed weapons.
Lap decks. Don't worry, we double bagged it. It's okay.
Double bagged it.
It's also in a magic void. It's not leaking on anything. It's just gonna stank when you take it out.
I mean, that's what magic's for. Let's be real. That's the real invention of magic. It's like, just to clean shit up like that. Can I viciously mock the corpse so that it just doesn't stink in my bag anymore?
Yep.
You stink. It's not that.
There we go. I had to clear my throat. But, after a little while, The announcer steps forward and says, "People, come and listen. Well, today, in one of our shortest tournaments, but not the shortest, we will never forget nearly 20 years ago when we had a one-day tournament. However, today... we have the grand finale. where we see the representative of Dol Guroth, a newcomer, along with Count Talon Drokath. The crowd predictably goes pretty wild. The nobles mostly give like a polite like clap.
Golf clap.
And And now let us see our champions. And on cue, Talon exits his little room. And most of your side of the arena goes pretty crazy for him, whereas the noble side is more or less uncaring. Most of the people who are cheering for him are people who are foreign from here. You're talking a couple of representatives of the Kerala Alliance, a couple of people from Silverfall. The Dwarven King is very much into this. But, most of the Crossway nobles outside of Lazar, who's giving a polite clap, is just not caring.
Right. Typical. Does he look all
right? Talon looks fine. He looks grim and centered, but...
Grim?
You know, he's serious. All
right.
Determined. You know...
Yeah, just sort of grim-faced. He's very serious-minded. But yeah, goes, and now, the champion of Dol Guroth! And from the other side comes the Black Knight.
I'm not dead yet.
Not that Black Knight.
Just but a scratch.
Oh, gotta be on the right layer. Ha 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 ha.
He takes up a 6x6 square.
God damn it, John. How do I do this?
Is Sean rolling a physical die?
No.
No, it's me.
Oh. He's terrifying me. Just like, what the hell is
he
rolling?
I do that when I get bored.
There we go. Switch my layer back again. All right.
Ooh, look at him.
Fuck.
He looks cool.
Wow.
Oh, I really wish we could loot him.
I'm gonna try.
That's a lot of spiky things.
Yeah, but imagine what I could do once I melted a tanker of the ass down. Oh, wait, that's a great sword. Oh, fuck.
Sean's been pretty good about us not letting us keep boss loot.
No. He's giving us boss loot. He's never giving us the bosses.
That's what I meant.
We've still gotten chunks from them. We just don't get any trophies anymore.
You've been collecting chunks of people?
Yeah, what the fuck? Are you?
We have the Nazi. We have the Manticore skull. We didn't get any of the stone from the Marble God. I still have the arm from what they did to the kid.
You have a really weird collecting problem.
Fuck you! He did it first. Same team.
All right, this is a very long dramatic pause and drum roll.
Yeah, I was listening to you guys.
This is real entertainment.
Yeah, we're just in the stands not paying attention, bickering about like all the weird shit we've collected.
Sounds about right.
This whole time Talon's been looking at Coat to squeeze the thing into the I'm getting my ass kicked, please help.
The announcer waits for the crowd to quiet down for a moment and finally says, and let the finals Figgin! Talon draws his sword. You can see that he's not actually wielding his, basically the violet blade.
No. He doesn't have the lightning sword? What the f-
Why?
You can even hear from the actual arena, the Black Knight cocks his head and goes, "What? Do you think you can beat me without your precious magic weapon?" Talon gives a smirk and says, "No, I think I can beat you. I also don't think you deserve to face that weapon."
Oh, the Coat's ego goes up a little bit. I go, "Yeah, you take that!" And I give Talon inspiration.
Well, I don't think that can pass through the arena, can it?
Inspiration is just a dice awarding. I don't know how the actual description of inspiration
works. It's not really
works.
It's not magical.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
It's just me going, "Woo!"
And Talon not being pissed off anymore.
Coat pours some of his ego into a flask and throws it at Talon. And it really sparkles.
Wow. Sparkles. I throw it and it bursts and takes the shape of a unicorn.
Wearing a feather.
We're not sure why. We're not sure why. It just does.
The,
you know why.
The Black Knight just seems to grip his weapon tighter and says, "It's the day I've been waiting for. Where I earn my name and my place."
Nope.
He lifts his sword up and just rams it blade first into the ground. And for a moment, you never noticed this, but whenever you stepped into the arena, you could feel the slight tingle of magical energy. And the reason that you specifically notice this now is because it suddenly vanishes.
Void blade! Void blade!
As if on cue, blackness spreads out from the sword almost like a flood.
I immediately just try to get people out of the arena.
People are confused and curious, but nobody's really listening to you. As it seems to overtake the sort of the fighting pit and just immediately envelop the stands. Everyone begins to get a little concerned before you can see the what almost like the sky just simply vanishes into a complete blackness.
Hey Sean, is the populace literate? The general populace literate in this fictional world?
Everyone can speak and read common.
Speaking is easy. Reading.
We're not a read in this city.
Okay. Trick, fire up a warning flare.
Well, I can see in this darkness. What do I see?
You see that it is black. It's not literal darkness.
It's not magical darkness?
No. It is something that is black that is swarming everywhere.
Oh, so it's not...
We are standing in nanomites right now.
I look at Trickery and I just go, "Warning flare now! These people need to get out of here."
Would Nyx be able to tell if it was something living?
You would, but you can't. But it doesn't seem like it's something that's living.
Okay.
You notice a distinct lack of not living.
You feel something, however. You feel, specifically, you first begin to feel it before everyone else sort of has a similar lighter sensation of this same.
Is it
like a small pulling sensation? Hole? Just like at the base of your stomach.
Black hole?
And then, Trick, you can see beyond the arena. Most people can't. You can, because of your specific boon.
Yeah, my devil's sight.
You can tell that you're not in Crossway anymore.
Oh, we did not just get gated.
The arena begins to tremble, and you can feel it actually being lifted up.
Well, now people can't really run anywhere.
Oh yeah, we're stuck here.
Oh, jeez.
Okay, I tell everyone, "Hey, guys, we're not in Crossway anymore."
Bree, this is not a time for jokes. Although I did like that movie.
What's a movie?
I didn't realize I was referencing something.
Who's Bree? We're not in Kansas anymore?
Oh. Yeah, I was about
everyone
to suggest
that it's
Nyx
a reference.
It's a little black dog.
Anyway.
A little black dog. Turns into a terrier.
So,
it's like,
so,
okay.
I'm sorry. I don't think I'm understanding this blackness. Is it around us like a bubble and we can see each other in it? Or is this like basically staring into a void individually? Like none of us can see anything.
It was wrapping around you. Now everything sort of just appears to be black. With the sort of the top of the open arena, not it just seems like it's black to you guys, but Bree can or Trick can see some like depth to it now.
So we can't see each other. We're all blind.
Well, you can see each other. People can see each other, but it's
okay.
Just,
that's what I meant. It was like within created... this bubble, we can see each other.
Yeah, there's okay. Sort of you can see like I would say you can see that there is sort of light, but there is no source of it.
He's turned us. He's put us all in a Thunderdome.
That's basically what I was afraid of, but
and,
yeah.
And Thunderdome's in another dimension.
Oh, really?
I imagine we're not. You said we're not in Crossway anymore. We've been
as
lit,
you feel things moving. You feel things moving faster, rising up as the crowd begins to freak out. The nobles begin to freak out. Everyone begins to freak out except for the Black Knight and Talon and you guys, basically. Though you guys might be freaking out a little bit.
Oh, I'm freaked out a little bit.
Wait. How far are we from the nobles?
They're
the
opposite side of the arena.
Side of the arena.
I need permission to do something, so it's like this is clearly not allowed, right?
After, oh my gosh.
I don't know.
This is clearly not allowed. Someone disqualify him quickly.
Well, A, that means coat one is bet. B,
yeah,
I don't think we should be fight. He shouldn't fight him alone.
I worded.
Yeah, I'm waiting for one specific moment, and then my ass is in the arena.
Same here.
After you toss me.
Yes, fine. Get over here.
All right. So then, what happens?
The Black Knight removes his blade from the ground, and it seems like everything goes black as whatever light sort of that had been anchored to this area goes out before another light is cast upon you guys from the top, from like above the area, and suddenly you can guess where you are as two bright, almost brilliant sun-like eyes look down upon you.
What?
Oh, fuck.
Galactus?
It's a gay dragon!
Wow.
What?
It's a Galactus?
And based off of how things are shifting and moving, you think you can tell that something is holding the arena now.
Oh, hell no. Oh,
hello
hell
again,
no.
You of the magnificent scales.
Well, that it's not a dragon.
Aw, darn.
I think we just need to let him finish. This is not good.
You think?
Trick, you can see a vague outline of some sort of creature that appears to be entirely almost wrapped in this darkness. But the only thing that is truly visible are these two sort of, as I said, sun-like eyes, which are casting light upon everything.
And it's carrying the arena?
It's basically, think of it as sort of like a curious individual who's literally lifting something up to look at it.
Oh my god.
And you can hear the Black Knight
cackle
as he sort of reaches out and he says, "Hear me, Sovereign Lord! Witness my sacrifice in your name!"
I use thaumaturgy to make my voice louder than his and say, "No, don't listen to him!"
Make a persuasion check against the god.
Stop.
Persuasion check.
DC 5000.
Natural 20. She wins.
Natural 20. Natural 1, yeah. Your head explodes.
Nyx is now thoroughly disappointed that it is the sovereign.
Just so crestfallen.
Put you on the right layer now.
Oh no, are we fighting a sovereign?
Wait, oh fuck, what is that?
No,
not these guys again.
We're being held by a sovereign. Oh. Not these motherfuckers.
Ah. Did they just appear?
Yeah.
Oh,
as
my God.
As the knight seems to get ready for an actual fight, the stands start to fill up, or I shouldn't say fill up, seem to have a bunch of extra guests as.
Oh my God.
The same black knights who met you in the tomb begin to pull themselves out of the black floor.
You can stop now.
You just had to beg him, didn't
so
you, Tarek?
Are they surrounding us, or are they just threatening everybody? Or are they threatening the citizens in the stands?
Oh, so you said the place is pretty packed, right?
By the way, yeah, the place is pretty packed. Oh, people no. are panicking and freaking out and basically clearing spaces for these people.
Okay.
Where are they going? Like,
they're coming for us. I have the funny feeling.
Away from them.
Okay, so these guys just—they're not spawning all around the arena. They're spawned around us, basically.
No, they're spawning around the arena, but
people are shying away from them in clumps.
I don't exactly have a gigantic arena-sized map, so I'm gonna deal with what I've got.
Yeah.
Imagination.
Imagination. But yeah, basically they are appearing everywhere.
Okay,
can I look to Talon and see where he's looking, if he's okay, if he's panicking, if he wants our help?
weren't we given a stone for just this problem?
Kinda.
It switches me in with him.
Yeah, I don't want any one person with that knight in there.
I think how about Talon keeps the Black Knight at bay, and if he gets his ship wrecked, I teleport him out, we heal him, and then I go back in and I just keep him busy. While the rest of us handle these assholes.
Right. Because we did so well the last time.
When did we have a teleportation stone?
What?
Talon gave it to Coat at the end of last session last night at the Golem's Arm. He said, here, you know, if there's a problem... I'm not gonna do this.
Okay, I remember.
Yeah, I'm not pleased about having to do it, but at least I know how this one works.
You want to give me the fucking thing?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm not pleased about your thing is base since my thing is teleporting. Leave me alone.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying Ledger would legitimately hold out her hand and try to trade places with him right now.
I'm saying let him fight that guy. Keep him busy, because.
The player understands the point. The player understands the point, and the character is having a panic attack at the moment.
The newly married wife kind of doesn't want to see her husband die.
I imagine the husband doesn't want to see his wife die either, though.
Perhaps not.
is there anything preventing Ledger from just going into the arena and helping Talon?
No,
but I don't want to abandon you guys either.
Hmm.
All right, Tarek, all right!
So what happens?
Roll initiative.
Yeah.
All right.
Waiting for it.
He said the thing. Let's do
we
the
have
thing.
To wait for the initiative order thing to go up, though.
Oh, yeah. Sean, yeah. You're fucking us.
Right about it.
Damn it!
Damn it!
Damn it!
Yeah!
Aww.
Throw me. No, I got you, baby. Don't you worry. Don't worry, fam. I got you.
I was looking at my spell book and I completely forgot about the initiative thing.
Initiative. What level spell is that again? I'm sorry. I don't mean to tease. That's just funny.
Wait, doesn't haste give you advantage on initiative rolls?
No.
Should.
I think it just doubles your movement speed and gets you an extra attack.
And
anyway.
Oh yeah, the AC bonus too. That's a good one.
Damn it. Go through it anyway.
Are you gonna sniffle and cry now?
DS12? Are you kidding me?
Oh God, I'm dead last. Well, you know what? I can make that work RP wise.
Yep. Both of the fighters are just in the back.
I mean, you barely qualify as a fighter anyway.
I thought he was talking about Talon, and I'm like, dude, he's a 15.
I'm concerned with our party.
I thought he was talking about me.
You're a rogue first.
And fight!
Shit.
Well, that escalated quickly. Alright, well,
do we have any epic music for this?
Hmm. Which way are we going here?
I don't know. Do you want to fight guys or you want to fight the Black Knight?
I don't know. You're kind of setting the whole, you know.
I'm asking you what you want to do. I look at Tara and I go, where?
I don't know.
All right, I'm throwing your right side then, because that's where the casters are.
Okay.
Let's see. Strength check. I can imagine just make a save for 50. Yeah, there we go. 24 to hurl Tarek like a javelin at this guy.
All right. You managed to heft him and can I, throw.
Can I use heavy weapon fighter to
no.
I imagine he's heavy. He's heavier than a weapon would be. Why couldn't I?
It only works on melee.
Oh.
I could have jumped that.
I mean, at 24, I'm basically throwing at Mach 2.
Make sure you guys go after the same like group of enemies so I can take care of the other side.
Okay.
So I guess we all go up. You hit north. You hit.
The trick. South. You go before half of us anyway. So
well, fine. Yeah, but yeah. There's still coat and rocks. So I'm just. Giving
yep.
some warning.
All right.
Well, I mean, so that's unless one you're attack. Gonna move.
Yeah. Well, that's one attack, right?
Okay.
No, that's an action.
Oh. Okay. Well, then. Yeah. I'll scoot up to this guy.
All right.
And then I'll use inspiration on. Who goes next? Nyx. I'll use inspiration on Nyx.
All right. I have to move the turn order because it was right on top of everything. I'll, shoot. Should I go ahead and cast Moonbeam because then I can move it, or,
You do what you want, boo-boo.
It's like, I'm deciding between Moonbeam or summoning another couple bears and then turning into a bear and just kind of, like, going all bear at these
No, guys. I think we need a bear cavalry right now. I appreciate that.
Wait a minute. Coat, what's your strength right now?
21.
That's strong enough to throw a bear.
I can throw a lot of things. I can carry, like, 400 pounds, like...
Okay, but summoning the bears doesn't mean that they automatically attack right away because they get their own initiative roll.
Yeah, I can lift 630 pounds.
Yeah, they're so probably not outrolling anyone. Which is a good thing.
So I conjure two brown bears because they're one difficulty, so I can conjure two of them. And... I then turn into a bear, but then that takes all of my moves, so I can't attack anything yet.
That's okay. Now we have a wall of bears.
Setup is still good.
And I have the attacks for the bear claw and everything in my stuff, so I can attack for the bears.
And they have multi-attack.
Exactly.
That's six attacks.
Oh, shit.
Jesus Christ, you scared the crap out of me!
What got real?
Oh, brother.
So I'm guessing the two bears get conjured within 60 feet. So how far is that?
60 feet is what?
The other end
of the arena.
The other end of the arena. I could cast these bears on any empty space. Okay. In that case, I'm going to go ahead and put one bear over here and another one over here. Just to kind of give us more protection here.
Sean, are you going to fight for Artax?
I was just typing that. Seriously.
Yeah, I was like, is he with us or is he like slept in and
he's Mark right now. Like he's just standing up in the corner looking triumphant and heroic.
Well, at least he can be a meat shield.
He's like, no, he's standing in front of Trickery. He's a meat shield.
There's another enemy on the far side of the arena. What's he doing over there?
Oh, he's just popping
up all over the place. Is he?
They are.
I assume
that's why
he's over there.
He uses that for initiative.
I use that for initiative.
Oh, okay.
So if we destroy the one that has initiative, it doesn't go away.
Bears eat everyone in the end.
The sovereign was a bear.
That's a bear cake. That was adorable.
Alright, where are these bears going?
One here.
One there and one here.
Somewhere over here ish? Oh yeah, there.
Where are these bears going?
And now the bear need initiative.
Okay, did Nyx ever discuss doing this? Because at this point, I'm freaking out.
fucking bears, guys! Giant fucking bears!
I don't know, do you have a bear phobia? Because I think you'll be fine otherwise.
Basically, Nyx roars as the bear, and then the other two bears roar to answer her, so...
Bear fan.
To try and let people know that, yeah, the bears are on our side.
That totally does it.
Don't worry, guys. I'm here to help.
It's like the beginning of Brother Bear. Coda, shut up. I don't speak bear. I've offended my dog. He just looked at me indignantly like, bitch.
Your dog thing,
dog offense, only on Zach's stream. Yeah.
So nobody's actually attacked these guys yet.
We can't.
Haven't gotten around to it.
Nope. Just getting ready.
I was throwing people.
I summon bears and throw
Well, the bears need an initiative roll.
Yeah, the bears do need an initiative roll. How
they may
do
go
I
next.
Just...
You roll initiative and then you look up what a brown bear's stats are.
But I can't select them. How do I do initiative for them?
Oh, just roll it and Sean will put it in there, I'm sure.
Brown bear, you're looking at they have zero dex.
So just giant lumbering wall.
Roll a d20, basically.
Yeah.
Okay.
Giant lumbering hulk of fur and teeth.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
That's right.
Nice.
Unfortunately, that technically puts him at the end of the initiative.
Shut
yeah.
up, bear. Bears go. Same team, asshole.
We need that t-shirt for our group.
Mean that the bears go right away?
They should.
Or at the end of the turn. But,
I feel like it should be the same thing as Bigby's hand. If he conjures it and then gets to smack something with it, you conjure bears, they should get to smack something.
Alright,
Sean?
Dude.
I'm going to allow this.
I mean, you should. It's the rules.
What was that?
But it's also Sean.
Okay, and flanking works from one side to the other. So if I moved this bear over there...
Yep. Yeah, then Tarek would have flanking too, I think.
Okay.
Except he would also incur a...
opportunity.
Yeah.
Put one right. bear... Put both bears on the opposite guy, opposite side of the guy that Code's fighting. Then they can get flanking to each other.
Is that a space opposite there that the bear can actually move to, or is that a wall where the bear can't attack that from? Or does flanking work this way too?
No, flanking doesn't work catty corner. You would have to put the bears, like Trick said, above and below.
Oh.
At least one of them would get flanking from the other.
Yeah,
I mean, they both get it.
They can triple team that guy and take him out.
Oh, God.
Focus.
You know, that sounds like a fantastic idea. So one bear there, and they both do multi-attack.
Woo! Four attacks on that guy!
Hold on, I'm sorry, I missed that. Where are these bears? I'm guessing they're here and here.
Yes.
Okay. Everybody ping quick.
I went to
all the pings!
So they get
all right, we'll perform your multi-attack.
fur bear.
You say fur bear?
No, that's 2d20 per bear.
Yeah, they got plus 5 to attack.
That's more. They have multi-attack.
Wait,
I have to do the d20s first, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
One hits. Well, hold on.
Wait,
that didn't do it right.
That's an 11 and a 9.
Yeah, 11 and a 9.
What? I'm confused.
What was
that? She's getting an advantage on each bear attack, so there's going to be like 8 rolls.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now it makes more sense.
Yes.
Yeah. Roll again for the same, or for the bite. It's just a claw and a bite.
Okay.
There you go.
11.
And I roll twice for each of them, right? Or
that's your one twice right there. That's one bear's attack's done, so you need to do the other one.
And then do another claw.
Okay.
Oh, too many bites. Too many bites.
Nope.
Oh, wait.
Just the last bite.
Yeah, no, it's
we're throwing too many dice here.
I don't even know what her attack is anymore.
All right, so remember you get a bite.
I only meant to do one bear claw, one bear bite, one bear claw, one bear bite.
Yeah, roll 20 right. Sticks.
All that matters is one hit for 11 damage.
Yes.
Yes. You've managed to somewhat maul this guy.
What a
but he's definitely
stuff.
Terrified being surrounded by a bear in a coat.
No, he seems pretty calm.
No, he's definitely terrified.
It's a shadow being. They don't give a fuck.
Well, I mean, he appears flesh and blood. He is bleeding.
Oh, the turn order jumped back again. I just noticed that.
No. Yeah, it's actually...
It's fine. He'll skip ahead.
This is where Talon gets wrecked.
Yep, this guy is charging forward to attack.
Hey, where'd Talon go? Oh,
nice knowing you, Talon.
I mean, at least, unless he takes like 80 damage in one swing, he should be fine.
Why would you? Oh, dude.
Oh, for fuck's sake!
Oh my fucking god!
Oh, shit!
Tell me he's wearing the whole shade of armor.
I'm going to kill you.
He's not taking 80 damage. It's impossible.
Stop talking!
We've never seen these void blades crit.
Why don't you just? I can actually do that with poison.
Let's just wait and see what happens, please, and we'll decide if I have to kill you later.
I mean, I didn't kill your husband. Sean did. You have misplaced anger issues right now. Sean's over here killing your husband, not me.
Technically, that would mean we inherit the keep.
Jesus Christ!
Holy! He could have taken 80 damage!
Oh my god.
I mean, no, but you're still close.
He could have technically gotten close to 80 damage.
74 would
but
be
no,
the
he took 50 thing. Damage.
Very many crap.
It basically, Talon moves the sword up to block, and the great sword shears through his sword and cuts into his armor.
God damn.
Fuck, the slashing Save motherfucker.
Does he scream up, tag out?
He doesn't scream. He does, however, cough up blood.
Ugh.
Not good.
I have to wait for my turn to give him another sword, don't I?
You have it?
I have another. I don't have that sword. I have my sword because I have my spear. I have two weapons. He now has a broken one. Do I have to wait for my turn, or is it a free action to throw him another weapon?
Well, it's now Talon's turn.
So your answer is no.
Talon crushes his stone and warps you in. Oh, wait, he could.
Uh-oh. Yeah. He said, uh-oh.
Talon is sort of in shock for a moment as he's just staring at this blade that's now somewhat in him. Before he cocks an arm back, the shield collapses onto his arm with the sledge at front, and he attempts to punch this dude in the face.
Get him!
Actually, it's the same bonus. Awesome.
Woo!
Just to hit.
Wait, 24 manages to hit? God damn.
I mean, I was just... I was looking at the straight 15. I was like, okay. With the bonus, that'll do it.
Okay. scare me a little bit there.
So, actually, he is going to attack him twice, so.
Get him.
And he still has inspiration for damage.
He does crit, though.
Nice.
He's got inspiration. So if I give him inspiration die, since I did, does he get, does that double when he crits? Since it's technically rolled dice?
That doesn't. I don't think that does.
No, it's technically not rolled for the attack. It's extra.
Yeah.
Well, damn.
Yeah.
Yeah, or else Hunter's Mark would double. And...
I'm trying to help out Ledger's boyfriend. You guys are like, no, no.
Hunter's Mark does double.
But again, it's only for that person.
Yeah.
I'll have to look up and see what people think about inspiration later.
Yeah, there's some weird gamey shit you can do with that. It's not very specific.
So.
But yeah.
Tall, dark, and Chungus is looking?
Well, give me a moment.
Here, baby.
I sadly don't. Hold on. I mean,
yes, you did. Here.
This thing still has most of my die rolls saved.
Right. Emmy.
So give me about 5 minutes as I figure out something. I gotta go and look up my chat logs because I can't remember a few things.
We need to go to the deep web.
Holy crap!
What?
Like, hey, give me the chat log for this thing. What's the first thing? One of the first things I see? A roll from Dunaway.
Oh my god.
Who?
Exactly. Oh, man.
Exactly.
Jesus.
There's some bunch of 100D100s. I don't know how that happened.
Oh, because we get bored.
Well, I mean,
you might want to go a little bit more recently.
Probably faster to start at the bottom and go up.
You're faster to start at the bottom and go up.
That's what she said.
Heyo.
But yeah. Sorry, I'm still looking this damn thing up. Oh, there's bears.
bears!
Odessa. Okay, thanks, assholes.
What?
Because you guys decided to have this fight, I gotta scroll through this shit.
That's totally Josh's fault. You picked the fight.
Fuck's sake. Okay, there I am. Holy shit. Oh, okay. So I need to roll.
Massive damage ensues.
It would certainly be interesting.
What is it you're looking up? Talon's punch ability?
I actually am.
He didn't expect Talon to survive and be able to do something.
Yes.
Well, I had two hits. Yeah. But he punches the guy's helmet once. And he doesn't seem to break away, but he cocks back again and just hits him right at the corner of his head, denting in part of the helmet and breaking him away. The man slides back a little bit.
Adjusts his jaw just a little.
Well, you could just see a little bit of red liquid dripping from part of his malformed helmet now.
Talon lick his fists?
No.
Ew. Uh-huh. He doesn't have another sword on him, does he?
That's fucking gross.
Actually, you can't tell. He's kind of... He's got, like, a cloak on over his armor, sort of.
We walked here with him. We couldn't tell if we had two swords on?
She probably helped dress him this morning.
Your hands and eyes were somewhere else.
You were moderately distracted.
Ooh, give him more.
Alright, it's
not for the turn. Okay, I see that you guys have that side covered, so I point my finger in this side and I cast Fireball.
Shit. Oh, Jesus.
I'm so glad Trick went before me.
And I duck.
Ah, too many ones.
Only two.
But yeah, everybody shield your eyes.
I'm just gonna, these guys are kind of heavily armored. There's three of them in there, so I'm just gonna roll these. Add two to each of these. Or, sorry, add one to each of these. Well, someone failed. All of them.
Yes!
All of them failed. All of them failed. Not even combined together do they even hit your DC.
They can't even Captain Planet this shit?
No, they can't even Captain Planet this shit.
By your powers,
because they cannot even. But.
That got me.
Yeah, it's my turn.
Yeah, fireball these guys, and immediately they burst into flames. The crowd screams, and a few
people are... Was there a crowd near them?
The crowd near them, but they're not, like, around them.
Oh, good.
But you can hear a couple of people goes, kick their asses!
Is the crowd giving us inspiration right now? There's gotta be a level one bard in there somewhere.
He's playing a kazoo.
Oh my god, that would be adorable.
It's like, oh, guess what? Giddy now plays a kazoo.
I think so. No, she plays Pots and Pans. Let's be serious.
That was her earlier work. That was her first album.
That was her pre Dulcimer Over a Goblin's Head.
Wow.
That's how she lost her dulcimer. She kabonged it.
El kabong.
Thank you. Somebody got it.
Yeah. No, I knew it, but that's basically what she did.
Oh my god, that's great.
Got it even.
Woo.
Oh, these guys go next.
Yep.
Glad you guys are between me and them.
Actually, that's probably a good thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll be honest with you. If I had gone before you, I'd probably already be in the ring next to Talon, so...
Oh, she abandons us for the husbands.
He's unarmed, as far as I'm aware.
Also, you have that cloak that gives everyone disadvantage.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, until she gets hit. Like, if you have a low AC, that doesn't really help you all that much. It just gives you an extra chance to not get killed.
Yeah, exactly.
Because the second you get hit, A, you're taking a lot of damage, you're probably going to die, and B, the cloak doesn't reactivate again.
That's terrible.
It is terrible.
Oh.
All right, where are they going?
Bring it.
Yep.
Sakoi!
Attack Arcanos.
Yeah.
I'm going here. I'm moving him right now.
Wait, what?
He's not here today.
He just threw our attacks out of the ring. Holy fuck.
Oh my god.
Then Bahamut came down like the Sims, picked up our attacks, and said, oh no, I need him somewhere else.
Picked him up and fucking dragged him somewhere. I love that.
He picked him up, dragged him, and he also took the ladder out of the pool. We are still here.
Nice Sims joke.
That one got me.
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10.
It's a shame they removed that. Oh, fuck.
Wood Sims again.
Oh. Can they move that far while they're on fire?
It actually gives them increased speed because they're running like hell.
That increases the flames. More damage.
Man, I wish you had a halberd.
I debated between Fireball or Hypnotic Pattern, but I thought damage would have been better.
Damage is better. We need to kill these quickly.
Yeah.
Hopefully you guys don't go down again.
Thank you. Thank you for that vote of confidence. I feel the love.
Alright, let's do... Oh, cool. I'm on the right thing. I just need to lower the number of dice. Against...
I like that.
Nick.
Yes.
Nope.
Just the defeat in her voice.
Nope. Yeah. That's 13. Does that hit your AC?
One sec.
It might hit the bear.
I don't.
Dramatic pause.
Like I don't have an AC.
I think
if she's
that
a bear,
hits.
Then it does.
Yeah, that should hit.
Oh no, Barkskin, damn.
Barkskin doesn't increase
that
AC.
Hits. I'll roll damage all at once. Against Tarek.
It's
resistances. Damn you.
Stone skin, wherever it was. Shit.
Against one of the bears.
That hits.
Wow, it chose the bear over coat.
Well,
the bear
hit him, so.
Yeah, I didn't do anything.
Oh, that's true.
And two against Arcanos.
Of course.
Well,
nope and nope.
Either hit. And one against Ledger.
Nope.
Ow. They didn't do any damage.
One did. One hit Nyx.
They hit Nyx.
Oh, he rolled all the attacks first.
Yeah. He hit Nyx and the bear.
Oh, okay.
And Tarek.
And Tarek. Yeah, he hit 21.
Oh, okay. I assumed because there's no damage, I was like, oh, none of them hit. But
I was like, oh, none of them hit me.
Okay, and how much of that does my armor take off? Just saying.
Nothing.
You're a Marathon.
Absolutely
armor?
Nothing. No, no,
your
that's
armor
right. I don't have any armor.
Oh, well, that
whatever
helps.
The bear's AC is.
The bear's AC is 11.
Okay.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
It's a giant honking bear.
Yeah, but it's typically
easy
like.
Hit.
Yeah, but it's the
same. They roll. Oh, it's got a bunch of hit points?
Yeah.
Not really.
Well, good for its
not really.
Level. Good for its level.
Oh, okay. I gotcha.
I can tell you at this point, she should be becoming a cave bear or polar bear.
Am I keeping track of the bears, or are you, Sean?
I guess I can. Against you, 15 points of damage.
Fuck.
Okay.
Black blade slides across your flesh. And against your bar, another 15 points of damage. So.
Okay.
Yeah, that's half the bear's total hit points.
Yep.
That's half of Nyx's total right now.
Well,
yeah, but then she turns back into herself with full HP after that.
Right, but
yeah.
I'm just saying, it's half her bear gone.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
And what did it hit me for?
Nothing. Two.
I forgot that it hit you. Give me a moment.
Damn it!
It didn't hit me at all.
Who said that?
Another 15.
Wow. What the? They hit jackpot.
Get rid of your dice. Just burn.
No. Eat shit.
Just burn them.
Okay, clearly these three dudes need to leave the battle, disengage, go to Vegas, and make their money there. Because look at that.
Lucky sevens.
They can't leave the arena.
With that type of luck, I think they can't.
We'll just F them out. Here, come on, guys. You're going to make it big. Whee! Strength check them out.
I cast Tucson or Bust.
Tucson or Bust?
Tucson, Arizona.
Yeah, I know where Tucson is, thanks.
Yeah.
I used to live there.
Also
why would you want
song.
To go to Tucson?
Tucson,
that's nothing
Arizona
to do with Vegas.
Yes, it is.
All right. Hey. The joke fell flat. Just let it die in its crib. Yeah. It's okay.
All right, it's Tarek's turn.
Did we ever... It's been so long. Was it a bonus action to apply poisons or an action?
I do believe it was an action to apply poisons.
Okay. I'll go ahead and apply poisons. I'm going to do draw poison. And then action surge and attack the guy that... Well, first one's going to attack the one next to Nyx, and the other one's going to attack the guy above me. Don't get advantage. Surprise.
Damn, those
that
hit.
Fits.
But I do get sneak attack. I'll do the sneak attack on the first one, which is next to Nyx. Sneak attack. So, 21... on the one next to Nyx, and 9 to the guy above me.
Well, shouldn't they both have acid?
No, I only have the one weapon.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then, but they both get disadvantage on their attack.
Alright.
That's good. Good call. Good play, Josh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's my turn.
Alright, it is now Arcanus' turn.
Alright. Question. If Bree takes damage, does her cloak just go away for the rest of the fight, or just
until No, until turn? The start of my turn.
Alright. And how good is your and Miss Ledger's dexterities?
I have a 17 dex.
Where is my dex? 14?
Not bad.
I could risk...
Well, what are you trying to do?
I could do 2d6 to all of them, but you two would have to make a save.
What? You're gonna risk injuring your own party?
You should probably not. You should probably not do that.
I don't have a lot of help.
I know. That's why. That's why I asked first. You. I didn't just do it. But yeah. All right. I'm gonna risk an opportunity attack by moving over here.
Come well, on. You're still within 5 feet.
No, the one in front of me is not.
Oh, you can hit
the one in front that of me. One.
Yeah, he still gets an attack of opportunity, just not the one right in front of him. That was right. Like, this yeah. one doesn't because he is still in range, but yeah. this one, that one does.
Yeah, I see it.
Alright, so I'm waiting for the swing.
Here's the pitch. And a miss!
Swing and a miss!
And, wait, with Sentinel, can't you hit that guy now? Or no?
No, that's not
a react.
Okay. And I'm going to introduce these individuals to my sword dancer technique. Damn it! Really?
Are you gonna introduce us to that? It?
Yeah. What the heck is that?
Oh, wait, it didn't save the name. Yeah, it was sword burst, cantrip.
Mike.
What?
My.
So someone described to me what sword burst is.
You create a momentary circle of spectral blades that sweep around you. He said, "Read it."
It's from. Yeah, but he said, "Remind him where it's what it is."
Oh.
It's a level 1 AoE spell.
Yeah.
Or cantrip. I don't remember what it is.
It's cantrip.
So basically, swords pop up all around you.
Everything around me needs to make a Dex 14 save. Or they take the damage.
I'm reconnecting right now.
Is that the one from Sword Coast?
Yeah, it's the Sword Coast Legends book.
It's add 1 to each of these. So how many? How many would be caught in this?
2.
The two.
Alright.
Really?
The other one crit, so yeah, they both make it.
Yeah.
Do they take half damage or no damage if that happens?
They make a dexterity save or take the damage. So I think they don't take anything.
Yeah, they don't take anything.
It would be pretty crazy if that was a cantrip.
It is a cantrip.
Yeah.
No, I'm saying like if it
was half damage.
Oh. Yeah, if it was half damage and you could just keep doing it, it would be crazy.
Fair enough.
It's only a D6.
Okay, I think...
It's 2D6.
Well, 2D6 because I'm level 5.
Still 2D6.
On a cantrip, yeah. That's still good. Alright. I think I'm back.
I can't do anything as a bonus action, so I'm just trying to draw aggro.
Ah! You just roar at them.
Now Ledger's turn.
I think a 9-foot-tall Will It Blend blender trying to attack you would draw some aggro.
What do you mean, Will It Blend Blender? You literally summoned a bunch of swords out of thin air.
Whereas I set them all on fire. I think they're probably more angry at me.
And then gave them a clear path to the caster.
A solid reminder that you are not a random mech.
I was going for more of the thematics of everything around me started getting cut, but alright.
Is Gundam.
That one was not the mech thing.
Ledger's going for it.
Oh, shit.
No, I can't. No, I can't.
Can't reach.
What I am going to do is I'm going to ask Sean, if I take one attack on the dude in front of me, is it my second attack I can throw my spare sword to Talon? Because I don't see another weapon on him. Like, I have the spear. Can I, like, throw my sword into the dirt next to Talon for him to pick up and use? Would that count as a second attack? Or
it
in place of
movement. Count as an action because you're trying to do an athletics.
So I would have to action surge to even hit the dudes in front of me.
Yes.
I can take the care of the guys in front of you.
Okay, yeah.
Honestly,
I'm just going to
throw the sword and look intimidating.
Yeah, I'm just going to make the athletics, you said?
Mm hmm.
Grr.
That gets you.
So I throw him my longsword, which is the +1 longsword from earlier, and
lands basically directly into the the arena right in front of him.
He gives you a wink.
Yeah, I'm not going to action surge to hit them. We're probably going to need it later. If Trick has more fireballs, then we'll be okay.
I got one or two.
We have eight. Enough.
Yeah, that's my turn.
All right, it is now Coat's turn.
Oh, is it? Oh yeah, hey, it is. All right, I'm going to shift 5 feet this way. And I'm gonna put the hurting on this guy right here.
Alright.
You get off my fan!
Oh, I could've...
She's the only one I have.
I could've disengaged and not take the swing. I forgot about that.
Yeah, it's weird, huh? Let's see.
How do you disengage and attack?
You just move 5 feet.
Yeah, oh, you can only move 5 feet to disengage?
Yeah, you can only move 5 feet.
I thought disengage was an action, though.
Like, how are you still attacking?
It's a movement action. It's a movement action.
Yeah, but it's an action to do it without getting hurt.
If you move 5 feet, you cannot take an opportunity attack. That's how things have always worked.
He just can't move anymore.
I can't move anymore.
I've never seen that happen.
I use all of my movement to move as carefully as I can away from that asshole to this asshole.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
I believe that was a house rule.
I've never actually seen someone use disengage and be close enough to attack someone else, so it's never come up before.
Yeah. They call it different things in different editions, but it's pretty much been a standard rule. At least in third.
Yeah. Swing your sword.
I'm trying.
Yeah, hit it or not.
I don't know. We're fucking talking.
Talking doesn't stop clicking.
It does. Where'd my clicking go?
Oh, for God's sake.
Well, no, I hit the buttons and it's not doing anything.
Oh, great.
There we go.
We broke it.
We're gonna get 50 of those now.
You managed to hit.
Well, that's good. So I hit him for 12 damage. And,
second attack going off?
Yeah, there it goes, I think. So,
yeah.
26 damage total.
Yep, 26.
That's what I got.
He is mildly injured.
Mildly injured?
We're screwed. That's what he's saying.
It is bar time.
But
bars.
Rar time.
Rar bar.
Well, I feel like they should just keep attacking this dude.
Yep.
Mm. Claw bite, go. Critical. Nice.
Beautiful.
Wait, why does it say zero?
You didn't put crit damage.
She doesn't have crit damage.
Oh,
there,
so. I didn't put crit damage.
2d6.
Roll another 2d6, yeah.
2d6 okay. Plus 4?
No, just 2d6.
No, just the dice.
Oh, yeah.
That would be broken.
That would be 4th ed.
Okay, there 16 we are.
Damage. Good claw.
That's one attack. You still have 3 more.
Now we need a bite.
Take some flesh. Take some flesh.
Get your pound of it.
Oh, come on. Yay! 17's a hit.
It is. I guess maybe.
I don't think we've established the 17 hits.
Alright, then I start the second bear.
Yeah.
Did that hit, Sean?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Cool.
All the damages.
Look at all this damage. Mahaha. Nice. Good bears. Hit. Remind me to pet the bears.
Bar. They get to eat the corpses after we lose them.
they're conjured bears. They aren't really flesh and blood bears.
I don't know how to give them treats then.
Wait, why would you want to feed them treat?
Wah, wah, wah.
Yeah, all I heard was treat and feeding.
No. I'm not going to feed an owl familiar to a fake bear.
Even if that fake bear is adorable and really hungry.
There's so much more to that sentence.
That's a Dungeons & Dragons sentence.
Right. Ow.
It is.
You will not hear it elsewhere.
No, in this house.
Bears basically maul and bite and maul and bite, and this guy just goes to that and goes down.
He didn't even need that.
Now the other bear can go.
Oh yeah, now the Nyx bear goes. This one I can feed treats to.
Okay, so Nyx is going to attack that one because she's very pissed off that she got attacked earlier.
Advantage.
Rip his face off.
I'm gonna take his face off.
Aww. Rip it off with your bite.
Yeah, yeah, you know, bite him right in the mouth.
Ooh.
Much better.
Is. And I forgot to do. I need to add on that.
That's another D8 there for that one.
A D8?
Yep, D8 for that one.
Bite. City bites.
Om nom 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 nom.
Wait, what type of bear is Nyx?
16.
Does it matter?
Yeah, because if she's if she's a polar bear, then.
Yeah, I think it's more damage. Why is her damage different than the other bears?
Because those are.
She's
brown.
A higher level.
She's a polar
Do
bear.
Do I add all the levels?
Bear. You're doing it right. You're fine.
Am I?
No, it's more my curiosity.
You're
doing
it. You're, well, you have
well,
your.
Well, we're not. Hey, listen. We're not going to sate his curiosity in the middle of combat. We could do it.
Yeah,
later.
Let's figure it out later.
You can learn. You can learn how to druid later, Matt.
We spent 30 minutes in a fucking dungeon.
No, nope.
Moving right along.
Mm-hmm. Anyway.
Moving right along.
Time for Talon to die.
Moments. Adding damage. Devon.
Wait, did we ever get an idea of how much health Talon had?
Not a lot left.
No,
about 80-ish.
When Zach fought him.
It's about 80-ish.
Okay.
He is once more moving forward for another chop.
Hop chop.
Hop chop.
Hey, wait. Talon can add the inspiration he got from Coat to his AC.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he doesn't need to, as.
Holy shit.
That's my man.
The
reason it was an even fight. But basically, he just deflects the giant sword. Before going in for another punch.
Punch. He didn't pick up the damn sword?
Not yet.
Damn it, woman, get off my back! I'll get that sword, I'm damn well ready!
No, that's the thing with Talon. It would wind up coming out completely politely, but that's what he'd say.
Yes, ma'am, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, I mean, he'd still be telling me I'll do it when I'm good and ready, but it would sound polite, like daisies. It would be so nice.
I want to hear him swear. Daisies fly out.
It's like that episode.
I love
French. It's just
Jesus.
Like ass with silk.
Wait, what?
It's
say it again, Sean.
I said I love French. It's like wiping your ass with silk.
Okay. I heard something way different.
And Talon is going to action surge.
Damn right.
Forward, scooping the sword off from the ground. Before.
Does a longsword do more damage than 2d10?
Plus one. It's a plus one longsword, and it does.
It's a d8.
It does 1d8.
It's a d10 if he was wielding it two handed.
I'm probably just going to keep punching.
That's a hell of a punch. I mean, he's got to
yeah,
be...
Like,
yeah,
he is, however, dual-wielding right now.
Oh.
He's dual-wielding punches?
He's dual-wielding his sledge arm and the sword.
So his AC just went up.
Oh, okay.
I forgot he's got that stupid sledge arm thing.
I thought he's been punching him.
Le punch!
I thought he was like half-monk or something.
Falcon punch, man. That motherfucker has a falcon punch.
This is my monk knight cleric barbarian. He has 5 attacks every round.
And I need.
Oh, he would, actually.
No, it's extra attacks
don't double.
Yeah, extra attacks don't stack.
No,
you're
right. About, correct. Flurry of blows.
Is that another attack, Sean? How many attacks is he
I
getting?
I fucked up. Don't worry about it.
He gets enough. He gets enough to hit that guy in the mouth again.
Yep. Another good old punch to the face. A good old falcon punch, as one would say.
I need to find that now.
Please, no.
Somebody give me advantage. I want to cry.
How do you get advantage? Flanking?
Yes.
Well, the guy in front of you has disadvantage anyway. Actually, they both have disadvantage thanks to your last turn.
It's on their attack.
Alright, it's not Trigger's turn.
Well, Trigger's just going to smile at these guys and say, let's do that again. And another fireball. Except I'm going to
for you.
You can cast it wherever you have to cast it. If it's a dex save, I have Shield Master. I'll be alright.
Well, I'm going to aim it behind them so that like the edge of the fireball catches those guys.
Oh, okay.
Nice.
It's not like I'm going to let them run away into me.
Much better.
Kaboom!
Woo! That hurts.
One to each of these.
Nope.
Yeah. I love fireballs.
I love their defensive rolls.
31 damage. Jesus Christ.
That's 31 each, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, there's no Captain Planet in that one.
Hmm. Another bear! Another bear. We were all so excited. Where did he come from? He's
about to be really shocked. I didn't summon that one.
Oh, no. Seriously.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Guys, they're still are coming.
Are these the ones that came running around the arena? Is that
they're
what that
forming
is?
From the... As sort of the area begins to clear out from both people dying and
fireball,
you know, these guys and people actually like consolidating into areas where guards are defending them against these guys. More of them are slipping from the shadows.
I want at least one noble to be screaming for Talon to save them.
I'm beginning to think the fight in the stands is a losing battle.
I'm sorry, you're lawful good, but...
based on what's been happening, Ledger's very close to an alignment shift.
I was going
to
say, that's fairly chaotic, I'm pretty sure.
I didn't say that Talon should let them die afterward.
Look, okay, Clint Eastwood, calm down.
Man,
did she kill those three guys?
Yeah, I was hoping that would take them out.
No, they are severely burned, but they are trudging on regardless.
All right, Ark, between you and me, we can sweep these three now. Wait for our turns, and that's what we'll do.
I'm not dead yet. Very badly burned. Got him with the Austin Powers joke. All right.
All right, it's their turn. Time for them to do things.
Oh, man.
By the way, when they appear, it was on their turn, so...
Yeah.
You guys aren't going to move.
Oh, good.
This guy is going to try to attack Tarek.
And has disadvantage.
Yes, he does. No, wait, that's the wrong thing.
Yeah,
definitely the wrong thing.
Go.
No! It was the wrong thing! Go back!
Hold on.
Disadvantage.
Lower result. He still hits, but he does not
crit. he doesn't murder you.
Why does he have disadvantage?
Because when Tarek stabbed them last time.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and anyone Tarek shanks, it's poisoned.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the one in front of Nyx has it too, but he hasn't gone yet.
He's going to attack Coat, actually.
Good.
Well, Coat got a hit off, right?
Go fucked him up.
Nope.
I say them as something snide about his mother.
Two against Arcanos.
Bring it! Shit! Why was I immediately cocky?
And one against Ledger.
Now I'm gonna die!
Oh. Nah, you're fine. You haven't even taken a hit yet.
I know. But now that I know what I'm doing next turn, like, one as soon as
Eric?
I decided, I realized I was
Eric,
gonna
you
die.
You take 10 damage.
I take 10.
Arcanos, you take...
Tarek takes 10.
11 damage.
Ugh.
And Ledger takes 10 damage.
Woo, low rolls on them D8s.
Hi, one-fifth of my hit points gone. Oh, you're going to come back next summer? Okay, then.
All right, it's now Tarek's turn.
Quit your belly aching.
Yeah, quit your bitching.
All right, that... You know what? No, screw it. I'm going to take the opportunity attack, go over here. and then hold my action until Ledger's turn.
Okay.
Well played.
Arcanos?
Wait, did you want to wait till Ledger, or do you want me to do it?
What about the opportunity attack?
Yeah, there is an opportunity attack. I forgot about that. Thank you.
Well, I came!
Asshole.
If you want to throw me, that's fine.
I mean...
He does.
Uh-oh.
And still hit.
God, you suck with your roll!
12 damage.
Like,
this sucks.
You want to go up to the big sword guy, right?
Yes, I want to ring.
Confirm that?
Yes, I want to go in the ring.
Alright. I'll throw him then instead.
Alright.
Fastball special. Athletics? Oh, I'm not good at this.
It's a strength.
And why did you say you would do it?
Because he forgets that he's a fighter sometimes.
Because you have a better chance to do this than I do. Like, it's strength?
Yeah.
Oh.
Because it's a very awkward thing, so it's not an athletics check.
We gotta practice this. Like, we need to play catch with Tarek.
I've thrown him before.
Yeah, we've got proficiency in this.
But you will soon.
He said that you will soon. you throw Tarek into the railing head first.
Yeah.
I'm gonna roll a straight.
Wait, would this technically count as an attack of some kind?
Okay. No. I tried already.
No, it does count as an action, though.
No, I know that. I was hoping I could use it as an attack as well. Because then I could fix that.
You managed to grab him and heft him.
And a ledger. Thanks!
What? You move me 5 feet.
you pick him up and you place him on Ledger's shoulder. Ledger is ready for her next turn.
No. It's like I picked him up like a football, and I tried to throw him, but I only clipped his
belt. Tarek, like, just flipped through the air and landed on his feet next to
him. If you fumble the ball, I will break my foot off in your hind parts, and you will run a mile. remember the Titans.
I know, right?
I love that movie.
Well, the good news is, at least it didn't use your triggered attack. So, I pretend like nothing happened.
Oh, don't worry. No one else will.
At least I didn't crit fail. Someone's gonna do that, and that's gonna be funny.
All right. Is that your turn?
Yeah.
Are you doing anything else?
No, that's me.
He can't do anything else.
Yeah.
Okay. Now.
But I could. It wouldn't help.
Now we're on my turn. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Question, because I have thrown Tarek successfully half a dozen times, do I get to roll the athletics check, or is it still just an unskilled strength?
She is the primary halfling catapult.
I am.
I am going to allow this.
Thank
and
you, Sean.
And give yourself a feat called halfling thrower.
That was a feat in 4th edition. Oh, I think I can find it.
I'm taking you seriously. I'm typing it in.
I want to think of a better name for it, but currently it's halfling thrower or halfling hucker, if you wish.
I was thinking halfling tosser.
Eh.
Shot put.
Nah.
Man, it's a shame he's not a dwarf, because that would have been really funny.
Yeah, dwarf tosser.
So what is the feat? I can use the athletics check instead of a strength check? Or straight strength check?
Yep.
Alright. And then I do my
You are
attack.
Now proficient in throwing halflings.
Isn't that also a skill in Pathfinder?
No.
And I do my attack.
No.
Oh. Sneak attack.
Well, I mean, you hit with the second attack.
21, and he's got disadvantage.
Against you or against anyone? I'm not clear on that.
All
he's
attacks.
Poisoned.
In general.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's fucked
and,
up.
And since hucking him is one attack, one action, I would now like to action surge and stab the guy in front of me.
Don't forget, you get two.
All action search gives me both attacks back. Thank you.
Yep, yep.
Look at me almost knowing shit.
Halfling hurler? Yeah, that works.
Halfling hurler, I like that.
Well, you managed to hit once.
I'll take it.
Short stack slinger. Wow.
The hack slinging slash.
That's legit good, because that...
It's not just halflings, it's just anything smaller.
Does that imply that she could also throw, like, Nick-sized objects as well?
Yeah, I'm going to allow this.
I really should have rolled a bard.
Yeah, you deflect a blow from this man before jamming your spear into his throat, and his body, you can just see flames just ignite out of his eyes and his mouth before you rip the spear out.
Oh my god.
Ooh,
fucking
that's
metal.
Hot. That's hot.
I see what you did there. Ah, you. Okay. Coat's gonna jump into the air and bring his sword down in an overhand slash on top of this guy, so I'm gonna try and use that to activate the heavy weapon fighter.
I will allow this.
Okay. Do you want an acrobatics check?
Yes.
Okay. Where the fuck did my character sheet go? Come back, character sheet. I need you.
That's comforting.
Come back, character sheet. You're my only hope. Basically.
I can't do all this from memory.
I mean, I probably could by now, but I don't want to. Wow, my roll 20 is just fucking up today.
Yeah,
all right.
It's pretty glitchy.
It's really slow and not really working all that well. All right, so we're going to do that. So this
Let me roll 100 d20s. That'll fix it.
That's 17 to hit.
That, yeah, barely
right,
hits.
So he takes 19 damage.
You managed to cleave him from shoulder to hip.
Woo!
Falls down in two pieces.
And then I move over here, and I take my second attack against this guy.
All right.
Why does my character sheet keep going away?
It needs some space.
Damn it. Whoa. Damn it, Amanda.
Oh. Too soon.
I'm sorry. He has a lady.
It's jealous of your new lady. That's what it is.
You're right.
There it is. That's fine.
Seriously.
It knows it's the side hoe.
Damn.
Okay.
Too bad it's not lady.
Damn, boy.
Yeah, there's no way for me to RP that into a big slash.
Ooh.
Oh, wait. So there's a railing right there, right?
Ooh. What? That was interesting.
Huh?
I lost. I'm losing power periodically.
Oh, like at the house?
Like it just like
boom.
Flashed off, flashback on.
Please no.
So when I move over there, can I RP a little bit and use the railing to jump up and
you're gonna make another acrobatics.
All right.
Sorry,
good.
I'm looking around like
let's see. Seriously, character sheet, stay here. I need you.
Sit, stay.
I know, right?
Just let me kill this man.
As slow as shit.
I don't want to clarify. I just want to say goodbye.
A 16 to jump off the railing and basically leap over him. And I want to. Actually, I don't want to do that. Actually, now that I scroll up a little bit.
Yeah.
I'd like to land right in front of him, between me and between Nix and him.
Yeah.
I'd like to cleave him in twain.
I'd like to tear him apart.
So that'd be a 19 to attack.
Yeah. Oh, that's...
And a 27 to damage.
Nice. 27, you say?
I do.
I only did 9 damage that one, so I don't know.
I mean, he's not dead, but...
No, he's seriously injured. You managed to open up a rather large wound into him.
Don't worry, we have bears for this.
Finish bear cavalry, ho! Huh? How big are these bears? Can I ride one?
They're large.
Yeah.
They're large?
Oh, yeah. They're large?
Oh, yeah. Shit, they take a... Well, wait.
Wait.
There you go.
They're fair. Yeah, they should be fairly large. So
is it Nick's also a large bear?
Yes, she is.
Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
Okay.
Trick duck.
Fair butt.
She's what? Oh, I guess she technically is bare-assed right now.
Shut up.
Oh, that was kind of embarrassing.
I worked on
really?
Shut up. Shut up.
You're gonna take meta damage. Stop.
You feel a deep, terrible pain in your brain.
Insane in the
as membrane. If some cosmic power despises you.
Oh, Clarence.
Oh, he's rotting in hell.
I think he's alive.
No, he's rotting in hell.
Moving right along in the initiative order.
Bear, bear, bear. Go, go, go.
Ding, ding.
It's time for a bar smile.
Bars.
Bars for days.
Get a bar.
Okay.
Go on, boy.
This one. I'll move over here and attack this guy. Okay.
Oh yeah.
Arr, this guy. All right. Attack.
With advantage.
Yep.
So that's it.
Oh, yeah. That's very disappointing.
Fight.
Oh. My neighbor's getting all pissed off again because I was laughing. Heaven forbid.
He's not having any fun, so you can't.
Hey, I don't know what his fucking deal is.
Who is it?
It's my downstairs neighbor. He's an asshole.
Okay, and then this bear shall move over here and attack this dude.
Yeah. Bar.
Bar.
Bar, I'm a bar.
Does that count as diagonal flanking damage if I attack the guy who's diagonal to me?
Yeah.
Or flanking advantage, rather?
It does.
Aww. Yeah.
Woo! Very excite.
Aww. Mm-hmm.
Much excite.
Nope. Bunch of misses. Bunch of misses.
Has that one taken any damage at all? Oh, sword damage, yeah. The dancy thing.
The bar.
Technically, because he didn't take any damage from that. He took damage from the
fireballs.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought the sword thingy got him,
they all
too.
Saved.
Nope.
Oh, all right.
They crit and crit succeed.
The other bear.
It all blends together when all these dice on the table.
The pretty bear go.
And then Nyx is going to attack this one.
Nom nom nom.
Nyx is going to devour this man whole.
Finish him off.
Shoot her.
Well, you managed to hit him twice.
For 17.
Alright, what is that giant squeak? Is that someone's chair?
Yeah, it sounds like it.
I think it's mine.
Get oil. Oil can, you big metal monstrosity.
It's getting annoying.
It's in character. I'm cracking my knuckles.
Quick, someone break out the lube.
Gross.
Do you have any idea how expensive lube is?
Yes, I do.
That's why you buy it in bulk, right?
I mean,
that's right. See, you go to Costco.
That's the section of Costco behind the bread. You need a password to get in.
As someone who is a Costco member, no, you don't.
You just need the card.
You need awareness of where it is.
We now know it's buying the bread. Okay.
You didn't hear that from me.
Anyway.
Swordman, go.
Oh my god. Give me a moment. I have to add damage. I didn't catch that. Nyx had rolled damage.
Rawr!
She hasn't. Oh no.
Did.
17.
Yeah, I did.
For the last two?
Yep, and Nyx claws the man. Disarming him before biting his head off.
Oh my god.
Like, that's just disgusting, but it feels good.
That's fucking gross.
It's amazing.
Yeah, Oh, wait, I was looking for that. Alright, well, this guy is going to the man in the center. He's suddenly very annoyed that there is a tiny halfling there.
That shanked him. Shivved him?
Shank.
No,
shivved him with a shank.
He is going to attack Eric and activate
his trap card.
He's
I was going to say that, but I was trying to, I couldn't remember his name for a moment. Activate Talon Sentinel ability.
Yes.
Hey, punch.
I'm pretty sure Talon is a monk. Like I'm almost positive.
If monks can't have sex, I promise he isn't.
Is that a crit?
God damn it, Amanda.
Amanda, you know that's not true. I gave you the book that had the sex monk class.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's a side class. But,
also, she didn't read it. Like, she's not a creep.
Also, tell me crit.
Yeah! Wow.
Yeah!
Yes.
Oh, he's a champion? Nice.
Yeah, of course.
He's a champion.
Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Damn. Oh, wait. Sorry. Fewer dice.
Still just as good. I'm happy with that.
So yeah, that's almost the same with two less dice.
Gosh. He decks. Guy right in the face.
And he flies to the other side of the arena, right?
Oh, he stopped the attack. Damn.
Does he land in the coat-shaped crater on the other side of the other thing, or like right next to it?
No, but he does slide back a little bit.
Oh.
Did he take an opportunity attack from me?
No, because he was lost.
No, yeah, you can't. Yeah,
he was forced out of the area. I got it.
Yeah.
And Talon's kicking the boss's ass.
He grabs at the this seriously impacted part of his helm, like around the eye socket. It looks like literally there is a dent in his skull at this point in time. It's like, no, I can't be. No. I will sacrifice everything for my dreams.
Oh, good, it's this guy. Oh, wait, last time someone said that, they'd be... Oh, fuck.
Dare to keep all your dreams alive.
Oh, no, don't tell me Sean's getting a picture.
You're in your head.
Please don't leave.
Then stop talking.
I don't know if I actually have it anymore. Dare.
Oh, shit, it is.
Your dreams alive.
Oh. I was talking about in general. Never mind. No. I'm okay with this being his final form. I'm perfectly
not so
okay.
Hard. Not so hard, Talon.
That's so weird. I've never heard that before. What an odd thing to say.
God damn it.
I believe the statement is not that, but...
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Well, the jokes you're making, I'm going to laugh if your character gets pregnant. I'm just saying.
Yep.
This has already been discussed, actually.
I wasn't sure if you wanted to say that. Yeah, that was already handled.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
Prestigitation.
Damn it, motherfucker.
My face hurts from laughing.
I know I can find this picture fairly easily, so.
Yeah, also, by the way, it's a 4x4, so have fun.
Wasn't the last one? Or no, it was 3x3.
No, it wasn't. Yeah, it wasn't as big, but it was pretty big. No, actually, the big golem guy was a 4x4, if I remember correctly.
Better not be immune to poison until I
get God damn it.
I'll find this one fairly quickly.
We are in the hands of a titan right now, so. Oh, wait, what if this champion loses? Is he just gonna drop us? I prepared the wrong spells.
I might have to grab a hard drive real quick. Because I know exactly what it is. It's just...
Alright, I will pause the video.
We'll take a very brief break in the middle of this fight.
Yes.